because he says when it comes to hair, he's in a class by himself. Why is there no one better than you, Giorgio?
Because everything that I do, everything that I feel when it comes to hair, I put all of me. Not some, but all of me.
To you live from Detroit, Michigan, USA. You are live from Detroit, Michigan, and I am your host, T. Carlita. You know, I always say where the true stories are told and great music is played, so we got some true stories and great music that's going to be played today. I've got an exciting show for you tonight. I got my man Phil the Mix, the happy smile guy. He's going to talk about what's going on and a word around the street that he was on fire this past weekend. So he's going to talk about that and a little bit more. But I'm really excited to have all the way from Berlin, Germany, a woman who is capturing electronic music through the clicks of her camera. The lovely Marie Staggat is here. And let me turn this down just a little bit. I must give a huge thank you to the Foreign Language Department at University of Michigan, both the Ann Arbor and Dearborn campus. I put a call out on Sunday afternoon that I needed a German translator, and I'm telling you that they stepped up and came through, and I'm so happy tonight I have Taylor Ann Lenz, who just happens to be one of my school classmates as well. We represent University of Michigan Dearborn, and she is also the German club president, and she can talk a little bit about that. So, another thing that happened in the news this week, I want to give a special thanks to Kara Boyer for writing a wonderful article about the show and the party coming up for ChevyDetroit.com. So I'm really excited about that. The link will be found on my Facebook page, so you'll be able to see it, and eventually I'll put the article on the website too. So I guess I should be quiet because we got to put a little Detroit in me by my man Andy Vaz. We're going to have a little German invasion tonight. So this is Andy Vaz, a.k.a. Vaz Up, little Detroit in me. And we'll be back in a moment. Hosted by T. Carlita, where the true stories are told and great music is played. How do you say hello in German? You gave me lessons outside.
Hello.
Hello.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. Guten Tag, Marie. How are you? Welcome.
I'm really good. Thank
Welcome to Detroit. Yeah.
Very
wow.
Happy to be here.
I'm honored, truly. And we did it so quick. It was like, hey, can I get a Skype interview? And you're like, I'm going to be there next week. I'm like, what? You want to come on the show? You was like, yeah. So I was cool. And I was like, okay, how's your language? She says, perfect. But Taylor Ann over here. So let's talk to Taylor Ann for a half a second. Let's talk about you as a student. And let's talk about how you got involved with being a German speaker, as you are.
I've wanted to learn German since I was younger. I don't have a reason. It's just a gorgeous language. And that was my reason.
Did she do good?
Yeah, very good.
All right.
Outside, so.
Okay, good. All right. So we're gonna do it, and if you need backup, you just look her way and she's got you covered, okay? Yay. So we just need you to talk to the mic.
Okay.
All right. So let's get started. So let's talk about, we just saw some beautiful photographs that you did from the Detroit mm-hmm. Project. One, and actually, I learned of you a little ways, just kind of almost recently. Mark Flash was on here on the show a few weeks ago.
Okay.
And his photograph is what drew me to you. The black and white that you did of him.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I was like, who did that shot? And it was tagged with your name, and I was like, oh, I'm a photographer, I got to talk to her. So how'd you get started with the Detroit Project? Where'd the idea come from?
I'm working at Tresor since almost 7-8 years. So that was the first moment when I got into the Detroit techno music scene. So Tresor is the oldest club in Berlin. There's a big relationship between Detroit and the Tresor Club since the beginning of the 90s.
Yeah.
So yeah, I started working there, and it was the first time. And I went to Detroit 2010. Because I'm very much into the music,
okay.
And of course I want to see how they are talking about history. So yeah, I want to go there and check out how it is.
Okay.
Yeah, and I fell in love from the first moment on, and was thinking about what can I do, creating a project with my loving for music and photography, and
mm-hmm.
yeah, I started the project then.
Wow. So how many people have you actually photographed in the project? Can you count anymore?
Yeah, of course I can count. I think at this point there are 45.
Okay.
Yeah, 45.
Wow.
But there's still a list with around 30 people, so.
Okay. And you're here to shoot, of course.
Yeah.
Can you name some of the people that you're going to shoot, or is that still top secret?
No, it's not top secret, of course. Yeah, I had some great shoots yesterday, and today I was at the building at Underground Resistance.
Yeah.
I had photo shoots with John Dixon, John E. Colling, Tunnel 7. Today I had Terrence Parker, Craig Huckabee, to name a few names. So,
right.
Yeah. As I said, the list is still long, so.
Okay, all right. So, now I'm a photographer as well, and I was fascinated by the black and white for one thing, because you gotta be really careful when you do black and white.
Yeah.
It can really go one way or the other, and you managed to do it so well. But I noticed there's a motif in your photographs.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the face, hands, up close. What's the concept behind that? What brought that idea? Because usually people just do full body, whatever, portrait, but yours are distinct.
At first I called it Hands and Ears Project. So my mission is to taking the pictures of the hands and the ears of the artist, because these are the important tools creating something. Music, I mean, also the heart and the brain, but I can't take a picture of that, so yeah. And I mean, you see so much history in it,
yeah,
like the wrinkles or something like that, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And also the close-up one, you see the soul, you see everything in their eyes, so I don't need full body shots, I can't use them to express what I want to express.
Yeah, they're powerful. I know one of the ones that you sent me with Juan Atkins,
yeah.
Oh my God, that shot is like so, like,
and that's the most famous one on that.
That's dynamic.
Yeah.
It's
thank you.
Yes. And why did you decide to do black and white? Why did you, or let's do it the monochrome. Why did you decide to go that way as opposed to color?
I love monochrome.
Okay.
I'm always into monochrome because it's a reducing, can you say reducing? Can you see it? Yeah, it reduced that on the important part of the picture. There's nothing which deviates, so it's just, yeah, you have gray, white, black, nothing more.
Mm-hmm. That's fascinating as well. So what will be the end result with the project? Do you have a, are you setting a deadline to be finished, or are you just doing it to until you get tired of shooting people?
Yeah, I put a little deadline on my schedule, but yeah, at the end I want to make a book.
Okay.
A Detroit hero book. So
nice.
With all these photographs, with the portraits of hands and ears, little interviews with some guys, little sketches or memories, wise words they write down on a sheet of paper. Yeah, I want to create a very big book of history. And yeah.
What we call the coffee table collection, where you the big fancy hardcover that the rich folks have in their house. Although we can handle it, we can do that too. Wow, that is really, really so amazing. So when it's done, are you gonna sell it online, or have you even thought that far yet?
Excuse me.
How?
I'm not sure yet.
Okay.
I mean, I will have to see if I'm doing an exhibition all over the world,
nice.
Making a book release or something. I think it's a good idea to sell it on the internet because everybody can get it then.
Right.
Yeah.
Nice. So. Well, let me know, because I cannot wait to see.
I will send you one, Tina.
I cannot wait to see the finished project. I mean, when I went on your website and I saw the photographs, I was like, wow. I really want to meet her. Seriously want to meet her. And you're here, so I'm also about that. So you're here in Detroit, and you're photographing. So are you just, now, as a photographer, I know you're photographing more than people, right?
Yeah.
So what has been some of the most amazing things? Now, you've been to Detroit before, because that's how you got them before.
Yeah.
So how many trips have you made to Detroit to do this project?
It's my third trips this
okay.
week or this day.
Okay.
But I mean, all the people are also often in Berlin. They're coming to Europe, so
you get them there too. Oh, okay.
Right.
Okay. So that's the other thing. You know, when you, as a photographer, you're looking for a set,
mm-hmm.
like you're looking for somewhere to shoot. And I'm hearing more and more that Berlin and Detroit have a lot of structural similarities. Is that true from a photographer's perspective?
No.
Okay.
Detroit.
I told y'all where the true stories are told. That's what I was told, and I had to ask.
No. Yeah. I mean, it's hard for me to say because I'm living in Berlin. So it's also a very inspirational city like Detroit. But when I'm coming to Detroit, for me, it's I could shoot on every corner.
Right.
Because it's like, oh, wow, let's do something there, let's do something there. It's a pure inspiration to be here.
Right.
So,
wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, would you like to say, let me see, it's, what time is it there now? It's 5 in the morning?
No,
it's 6 hours. I can't count.
It's
2:20. Oh, okay.
But I think my peeps are still in bed now, already in bed now, yeah.
They're in bed. Do you want to say something to them in language? You can speak to your people. As a matter of fact, I do this sometimes too. The connection with the techno, Detroit and Berlin. Explain it. They say there's a connection, and I know musically there is, but from a photographer's perspective, you see it differently. We see things differently. So tell me, how do you see the connection through the lens? What does through the lens of your camera look like for techno in Detroit and Berlin? What do you see in your camera? You can explain it.
Berlin
For me, it's always a pleasure and always a big fun to shooting people from Detroit or from the States. I mean, I also did some pictures of Chicago house DJs, and it's always so easy, very easy.
Okay.
I mean, when I compare it with Berlin and Berlin artists, they are always like, okay, I want to be serious, I just want to stand there, look into the camera, okay, we got it. And now when I'm here, they always, they're performing, they're acting, they're showing their souls, so
okay.
It makes everything easy for me.
Nice, nice. So we had a joke because you were hanging out in Chicago. You ready to do your Chicago project now that you've been there? Are you inspired to do that now still? Maybe.
Maybe.
Say, let's get this one done first, huh? So, as a photographer, how can people reach you? Like, are you just like an independent? So, are you also a photographer for hire, or are you just like almost like a filmmaker that does their own thing? So, are you interested in telling people how they can reach you if they want you to photograph them?
Yeah, they can reach me over my website or just give me a buzz or checking my Facebook page or something like that. Yeah,
cool.
I mean, I'm...
Yeah, and tell them your website.
It's www.marie-staggat.com, or, I mean, they can also check my Facebook page. It's Marie Staggat Photography, so to stay tuned for...
Okay, and you're going to be here for a little while, and I know that your house, and everybody in Detroit, we're going to take, matter of fact, we got people here that just hanging out because you're here. That's so cool. Mike, come on over here and get on this microphone. That's my big bro over there. Mike is in the house. Mike Clark is hanging out. And see, he was on the photo slide. I didn't even know you were going to be here.
Yeah. Yeah, she did a photo shoot for me. I think it was the springtime, correct?
March, yeah.
Yep, it was in March. And we had met, and, you know, I was, needless to say, I was totally impressed with the pictures and the layout and everything. And, you know, we just been talking through Facebook about some of the projects, some things that she's doing. I plan on going to Europe. Still working on exactly when, but I'm trying to do that. And you know, it's just a lot of work that I know that we may be covering on that whole situation. But I'm definitely glad that she came here to do this photo shoot, because the one that we got going on tomorrow, it has that Detroit historic possibilities. And, you know, blessed to be a part of that. And just her talent and her awesomeness. You know, she's very, you know, you can see she's a very nice person.
Yeah, beautiful.
You know, beautiful soul.
Definitely.
You know, definitely Detroit just kind of welcomes her and absorbs
Speaking
her.
Speaking of welcome,
yeah.
We got Detroit Techno Militia in the building too.
Come on.
So
hi, how are you?
What's happening?
What's happening?
Introduce yourself to the people that don't know you.
My name is T. Linder from Detroit Techno Militia, and Detroit artist, techno producer, and DJ.
Yes, you are. I was so surprised. I had no idea that she was staying with you. I had no idea. And I said,
She's family.
My God, that's so cool. So how's it feel to have, like, you all host? Like, this is the beautiful thing. I was just telling Marie, I love the way when the international guests come in town, you guys open your homes. It is so amazing the way you do that.
Well, for us, I think of it as being a very important thing for the international techno and house community to establish these relationships and kind of help be an ambassador for the city and show them around.
Yeah.
And show the history.
I love it. I appreciate you all for doing that. And I guess one day I'll have to open up my house too. Actually,
we are in your house. That's the name of the show, right? Your house is open already.
This is what it is. Yeah. This is what we do. This is what we do in Detroit. We love to show people our city. We love to show them what it really looks like. You know, everybody says whatever they want to say, but when you come, this is what it really looks like. And it's a wonderful thing. And Marie, I really, truly, I'm so honored to have you here. Do you have any last words? Say something in German for me, please.
Es war wunderschön mit dir, Tina.
It is a pleasure for me too. Was that right? Oh,
yeah. Thank you so much.
Don't ask me to say it though. No, how'd Andy Vaz say? Because Andy Vaz was trying. I did a Skype interview with him, and I asked him how to say something, and I said it. He says, "See, Tina, you're part German." So I think I did okay. I'm not gonna try to say anything else past that. All right. So we have now. We're gonna keep the German invasion going on a little bit. I got this job called Wet Job by Claus Bachor. Can you say his name?
Oh, Claus.
He says I say it wrong every time.
Claus Bachor.
Thank you, Bachor. I always said he was a whore, but you know, that's Claus. Claus will say that. He owns up to it anyway. So we got Claus Bachor coming up, my commercial, and then we're going to bring Phil the Mix in the building. He's outside there too. So he's coming up next. All right, let's see what I'm doing here. Oh, it would be nice if I switched the screen. So you guys continue to talk amongst yourselves.
Yeah. So, you know, and hey.
So what's happening in the city? What's happening in the city? I mean, everything is going on in the city. We got Kevin Saunderson in here tonight. And you got stuff going on.
Tomorrow we got art scene at the DIA Hall from 7 to 11.
Wow.
Yeah, so that's going to be interesting. It's like a gallery gala event type thing.
Okay.
And after that, Mich, which is our every Thursday schoolhouse.
Nice.
Me, Bruce Bailey, Earl McKinney.
Everybody.
Yeah, everybody. DJ Prez, everybody. Special guest. And I actually today, I haven't had a chance to even announce it, so it's actually kind of cool. I just landed a residency at one of my old places, which is Skybar.
Nice. Oh, yeah. I remember you were doing it.
Yeah,
oh, cool.
On Saturdays, okay. Matt Aubrey and Joyce and a couple other people, they
give
parties there.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Let's get Klaus in here. I got it going now. All right. Let's see what's happening. I got it. Oh, you got to see the way I hooked this up, because you know I do visual, so I had to come up with a
live
visual.
Live from Detroit, Michigan,
I had to come up with a visual.
You are in my house, hosted by T. Carlita, where the true stories are told and great music is played.
Joe.
Live from Detroit, Michigan, USA. Save the date and come celebrate the first year anniversary for the In My House Techno Music Show, Sunday, January 18th, 2015, MLK weekend, at the new Minjo's Complex, 928 West McNichols off Woodward Avenue, Detroit, Michigan, 48203. Doors open at 8 p.m. Show support donations are accepted at the door. Dance music is provided by DJ Dee, DJ Reggie Reg TM, DJ Raybone Jones, Derek Thompson, aka Drive Train, with MC 6-4 and Stacy Hot Wax Hale. It's going to be a great first year anniversary party for the In My House Techno Music Show on Sunday, January 18th, 2015. That's MLK weekend at the new Minjo's Complex. The address again, 928 West McNichols, Detroit, Michigan, 48203, and that's off Woodward Avenue. So load up the party bus and come get your dance on. Sponsorship opportunities are available. For more info, call T. Carlita at 313-516-9548 or email InMyHouse65@gmail.com. All right, we are live in house with my man, my brother, Phil the Mix. What's up, Phil?
Hey, 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 what's
going
on, Tina?
With that smile, you got it, you got it. Dude, listen, let me just cut to the chase. Let me tell you what I heard about you.
Okay.
We in the house. We at the table. We talking junk now.
All right. Let me see if you lying first. I got to see. Let me see if this is the truth.
Well, the rumor is that everywhere that you hit the box, it was on fire. They seen fire coming from underneath your feet, and you had it going on like that. That's what I heard.
It was just a little light, little barn fire. It was nothing.
No, said that they had to call the fire department on you because you was smoking like that.
Man, I don't know about all all that, but now you're doing a little something, something, Tina.
I know. So, where didn't you play this past weekend? Really, you be bouncing around.
You know, playing over here and over yonder's way
and everywhere.
Listen, I try and stay active as much as I can. I was you know, here and there, TV Lounge Friday night, and that's in Detroit, downtown Detroit. Also, I was at Saturday night. I was at Secreto in Ferndale.
Is that a new place or something?
You know what? It's a cigar bar.
Oh, that's
wild. On 9 Mile off of Woodward, and that's Ferndale. And it's a really, really swank, what do you say, really sexy place.
Really nice.
Very nice. You have to come check it out. It's a really nice place. I think you'd really enjoy it.
And it's in Ferndale?
It's in Ferndale, right on 9 Mile. So if you know where Como's is, it's on the other side of Woodward.
Okay.
So that's where it would be. On the same side as the Westbourne Market, I think that's where.
Okay.
Yeah, on that same side.
So do they get to smoke in there?
You know, what's unique about the cigar bar, Secreto, the front part of it is the smoking part of it, which is it can be heavy at times. But the back part of it, it's no smoking, which is nice. So it's actually two rooms of music. So so the back room, if you're not into the cigar and the cigar smoke, then the back room is fine for you.
Oh,
so
okay.
It really works for the ones that don't like smoke, and then the ones that like to smoke a little cigar, the front room is nice too. Nice bar.
You know what I really like about Detroit? We are really getting creative in where music is being played now. You know that?
It is wonderful the way, you know, someone made mention that we here in Detroit are spoiled. And I think that's a good thing because not many cities like us with the musical background has it like we have it. And I think it's just a phenomenal thing.
Right.
For all of us to take it in, and that's here to be able to experience it. You know?
I agree. So let's talk about Phil. We know you are the Mich.
Right.
Or is it the Mich? Because some people be saying duh.
Yeah, you know, that's the inner hood lingo version right there. But
what up, Phil? The Mich.
The Mich is the you know.
The
more corporate way.
There you go. So, actually, how long have you been doing this?
Good question. You know, I've actually been mixing and playing since 1988, which is not very long in a lot of people's eyes. But the thing before 1988, I was still a big musical fan of house music and music in general. I was... my father was a big-time jazz head. My mother was Motown, and that's what I was raised at. So the music is in my soul and in my blood. It runs deep, definitely.
Right, that's true. Now, it was a documentary. Mike Clark was just in here.
Right.
And
Mike, what up?
Yeah. Big bro ham.
Yes.
And somebody asked him a really good question. I said, okay, I'm going to steal that question because, you know, journalists have to borrow from others every once in a while.
Absolutely.
So what is in the mind of a DJ? Fill the Mich.
You know, and that's a good question also. And every DJ has their idea of what should happen in their mind. In my mind, I tell you what is the people, the crowd, them filling me.
Mm-hmm.
I think nothing but about them and playing for them. If they're not dancing, I'm not happy.
Right.
If they're dancing, that's what I want. I want them to be able to say, I dance like I haven't danced before in my life. So that's basically how I approach it. You know, like I'm gonna play like it's my last time.
I'm gonna be like the Dancers Anonymous. I am T. Carlita, and I have danced to fill the Mich. Trust me, I'm a danceaholic.
Yes, I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Matter of fact, you guys did something here in Highland Park where you guys had, we took it to the streets. It was so awesome at the McGregor Library there, Highland Park Festival. Remember that?
I remember that.
Yeah.
That was me and my partner in crime, Bruce Bailey. We did our Charlie and Brown thing, and That is so much fun. So much fun. And that was, I remember that day very well.
They were cutting up out there,
boy. Oh, my gosh. That was a lot of fun.
So, you know, being in the DJ booth, behind the turntables, because you do wax and you do everything.
Right.
So when you are concentrating on it, how are you able to, like as a DJ, I think, how are you able to multitask to be able to concentrate on putting your records on, and then also when do you, like in the DJ booth, when do you really have time to look out and see?
You know, that's a good question also. Well, you know, I'm very focused, and the ones that are really into the music side of it, stays focused, and you're just focused on moving the crowd and your music and what you think would be a great song selection to keep the crowd going. Mm-hmm. You know, that's and it's just focused, and the time, you know, and then experience too. You know, has been doing it as long as I have, and a lot of us, a lot of the other great DJs in this city, it just becomes second nature.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you either have it or you don't,
right?
You know, and I think it flows real good with me and a lot of us in the city. We definitely move it.
Right. So you do more of the house genre, or do you do both house and techno genres?
Well, you know, I dibble and dabble a little in the techno, but I'm more of the on the house side.
Mm-hmm.
And I also do a little R&B and a little bit of this, a little bit of that, old
right.
school and
exactly.
stuff like that. So I nibble and a lot of other little stuff too, you know. But the house side is definitely it, though.
And I know that I guess what I'm hearing a lot more, the house music, to me, is kind of changing a little bit. To you, or do you think, or what?
You know, it's changing a little, but for the most part, I think it's the scene is getting maybe a little smaller, and I think what needs to be done is we need to reach out to our younger audience and gravitate toward them and let them hear some of this good music, because I think a lot of them are missing out on a lot of this good stuff. You know, so I think a lot of us are getting older, and we're you know, we have lives and families and things like that. So I think in that way it's changing. But I think if you love the music, be it techno or house, it's going to always still be there in your heart.
Right.
You know, it's going to be there. It's just sometimes we just can't make it out as much as we used to.
True. That's true.
As we get older, you know.
So. Right. So let's talk about promotion. Now, you are part of a nice collaborative group.
Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about the collaboration process and why you all have actually been very successful at doing it for quite a while, actually.
Yes, you know, and I what I've noticed is, and it's a good thing, some people look at it negatively and some people look at it positively. I noticed with DJs, a lot of DJs, you form a somewhat of a team. Mm-hmm. And so when you create your team, you bond as a team and you work together to try and become a little more successful. My team, which is Team Tandem, which, you know, Bruce Bailey, Kelly Holmes, Steve Love, Mike Todd, you know, a couple of other guys, if I forget your name, I'm sorry. But, you know, we try and the whole object of it is a great time and moving the dance floor, you know, and which I think what the Techno Militia do, what I love their work and various other groups in the city, you know, we're all about the same thing, you know,
right.
moving the crowd and having a great time.
And that's know? The other thing when you mention Detroit Techno Militia, and you know, like even today is like a perfect example. Like people think, you know, the Detroit versus everybody, you know, seriously, Detroit versus everybody doesn't mean negative.
No, it's not. It's not.
At all.
At all, no. It's, you know, and like I say, we here in Detroit, we're spoiled with all this great music here. And I'm so glad that a lot of our old school cats like Delano Smith
yeah.
and some of the big names, Norm and even Mike Clark, and a lot of them get outside the city, they go worldwide to give the people what we do here that's in our backyard. We take for granted.
Right.
You know, but we give, you know, they give our love to the world. So and I love that about what we have here, you know.
Right. So how can somebody reach you?
Well, you know, I'm if you're in a city, you can definitely catch me at a TV Lounge. I'm a resident DJ there. That's downtown Detroit.
Oh, on what night?
On Friday nights. Okay. Usually on Friday nights. You can catch me on my Facebook, Phil the Mix. You know, that's usually you can catch me one of the two ways like that. And then I'm doing various parties around the city with my team tandem to also. So
right. Now you guys got you just had a, and I have to get up super early in the morning. I didn't get to make it, but you had the awards ceremony.
Oh, which was fabulous.
Please, yes. Yeah, and who were some of the people that
we
were honored?
Some of our legends here, yes, in the city. Gary Chandler, Al Ester, Stacy Hot Wax, mm-hmm, to name a few.
Right.
Even the ones that are not with us today, Ken Collier. Oh my gosh, just phenomenal. And I think that was a great thing that First Friday did to bring that attention and award those that's been doing it for a long time, right, in our city, and that's a great thing.
And I love that you all honored Laura Gavor.
Yeah, oh my gosh. Ooh, yes, Nancy.
Nancy
and we love
is
her.
Such a spark.
We love you, Nancy.
Yes. Oh my gosh.
And her sister, phenomenal. Yes.
Yeah,
so,
that is so awesome. So you got a mix that you put together.
Yes, I did.
So
yes, I did.
What's the level?
Well, you know, it's quite high. You know, as speaking of that mix, this is special because everybody's been waiting on this mix. So if you see me in the street, I might have a little something for you. People have been waiting a long time for a mix for me. So you're the first that has it, Tina.
Oh,
so,
shoot.
Yeah, this is very special. Very special.
A world premiere?
Yes, world premiere right here.
Hi, girl. I got a world premiere.
Right.
Well, while we're queuing this up, let's talk. Now, you're playing on Friday. Give the time, location, and address of TV Bar, because everybody don't know where TV Bar is.
You know, it's on Grand River, and I should know the address.
Just say next to Cast Tech.
Yeah, next to Cast Tech. But listen, we're doing a special thing, Charlie and Brown. We're going to be at Mix tomorrow with Mike Clark and a bunch of other, Earl McKinney, a bunch of other guys. So we're doing a special tag team tomorrow at Mix, so the Schoolhouse Project, so. We're doing that tomorrow. That's going to be a lot of fun.
All right. Phil the Mix or the Mix, depending on where you from. I appreciate you also. We finally got you on. We've been talking for a long time.
Yes, we have. I'm so proud of you, Tina, too. You said you were going to do it.
I know.
I'm so proud of you.
That's how far back
yes,
we go.
Yes, yes. Way back. You said, I said, do it, Tina. Do it. Right. Right. When it was just in this conception. So that's awesome.
So we're going to check out Phil here. Oh, shoot. What you know about that, Phil?
Yeah.
All right, Phil. Thanks a lot. Hang out. We're going to get some photos and hang out with everybody.
Sounds good.
So many people in the house tonight.
Yes,
I'm so excited.
I love it, too.
So we're going to listen to Phil the Mix, and I'll be back to close out shortly.
All right. Thank you.
You shouldn't have to ask for nothing, babe. No, no, no. You should have the world, babe. Right in the palms of your hands. Just tell me what to do to make your life a better life for you. Anything
your heart desires, desire.
See, I am born to make it happen, baby. All you gotta do, is tell me that it's me you want, loving you. And as long as you keep giving me that sweet love, point to it, baby, it belongs to you. If it's money you want, it's nothing. Want me to pay your bills, it's nothing. Buy your nice things.
Tonight. Well, this concludes the epic. I am so emotional right now. I promise you guys, I'm so ready to cry of joy and excitement. This night was just so special to me. I have to thank Marie Staggat for coming all the way from Berlin and being here on the show and responding to my Facebook. That was just so amazing. So let Facebook work for you. Don't let Facebook work you, okay? Work it. Don't let it work you. Facebook can really do wonderful things. And I mean, her photographs, as you saw, and check out her website. Trust me, it's more to see. She is a phenomenal photographer. Feel the Mix, love him too. Thanks for coming through. Mike Clark, my brother. Tom Linder, Angie Linder, Detroit Techno Militia. I didn't even know they were going to be here tonight, so that's even more special. And super duper hugs to Taylor Ann from U of M Dearborn, the German club president, for coming through to just make sure that our house guests was safe. That's what we do in Detroit. We take care, we take care of our people. That's what we do. I have to stop now. I really can't get emotional. I just have to tell you guys, set your electronic devices. Next week, I have the beautiful, lovely, international Kimmy Horn is going to be in the building. She's going to be in my house. And yes, she has a house story too. Y'all didn't know that, but I do. And she'll be here to talk about it. So until next week, I'm keeping the wheel spinning with my man, Dwayne Jensen. And we are in the right spot. In my house, hosted by T. Carlita. Enjoy the rest of your week. And I promise y'all, I did not try to cry tonight, but I just couldn't help it, you guys. I'm so excited right now. Woo! Okay, good night.